What you are looking at is a satellite view of not one, but two adjacent impact craters in the tundra of northeast Canada. Known as the Clearwater Craters, these two impact craters were for multiple decades thought to have originated due to a single impact event involving two closely spaced binary asteroids that were orbiting each other. However, recent evidence has shown that despite the odds, the proximity of these two craters within Canada truly is just a lucky coincidence. These large craters formed in separate impact events 174 million years apart from one another, between which three entire geological periods occurred. More specifically, the smaller Clearwater East crater formed 460 million years ago, while the Clearwater West crater formed 286 million years ago. And, well, yes, the edges of these two impact craters get as close as 1,500 meters or a little less than a mile from each other, you might be surprised to learn that they originally formed in different hemispheres in spots 7,560 kilometers or 4,700 miles apart from one another. Confused? Let me explain. First, their modern location. The two Clearwater craters can be found in a remote northern section of Quebec that is 1,200 kilometers north of Montreal or 130 kilometers east of the Hudson Bay. Both of these impact structures are massive, being both able to hypothetically fit the entire island of Manhattan within them, with the smaller eastern crater measuring 26 kilometers or 16.2 miles wide, and the larger western crater measuring 32 kilometers or 19.9 miles wide. So, how do we know that these two craters, which both lie adjacent to the same 2.5 billion-year-old rock unit, were not formed from the same event? The answer is radioactive argon dating. In this process, a rock sample is heated to high temperatures to release trapped gases within it, specifically potassium-40 and argon-40. The ratio of these two gases is then compared, since one decays to the other, resulting in a highly accurate age for a specimen. This process confirmed that the Clearwater East crater formed between 470 and 460 million years ago, while the Clearwater West crater formed between 289 and 283 million years ago. Also, the asteroids which formed these fascinating craters had vastly different compositions, implied speeds, and sizes. The first asteroid is tentatively dated only a few million years after a major collision occurred in the asteroid belt, which caused a 150-kilometer or 93-mile-wide asteroid to disintegrate into millions of smaller fragments, which then caused a temporarily increased rate of asteroid impacts by a factor of 1,000 in what is known as the Ordovician meteor event. For this video, I will assume that the impacting object originated as a fragment from this L. chondrite parent asteroid. Approximately 460 million years ago, a large asteroid which was low in metal and measured 2,520 meters wide was on a collision course with Earth. Accelerating towards the inner solar system, it reached a velocity of 11 kilometers per second or 24,000 miles per hour, eventually entering Earth's atmosphere. Then, only 14 seconds later, this asteroid impacted a shallow ocean in the southern hemisphere, generating a towering megatsunami and releasing energy equivalent to the detonation of 406 billion tons of TNT. Billions of tons of rock which were ejected due to this impact eventually fell back to the ground across a 500-mile radius, starting numerous fires. Many millions of years later, approximately 286 million years ago, a slightly larger and highly brecciated asteroid that originated from the differentiated crust of a larger asteroid known as an achondrite was on a collision course with Earth. Entering the atmosphere in our planet's northern hemisphere, this 2,600-meter-wide asteroid was traveling at a faster velocity of 17 kilometers per second or 38,000 miles per hour. Impacting a dense patch of rainforest a mere 8 seconds later, a colossal explosion occurred equivalent in energy to the detonation of 928 billion tons of TNT. Due to the sheer amount of thermal energy released upon impact, everything, and I mean everything alive in a 480-kilometer or 300-mile radius instantly ignited. Simultaneously, after the bowl-shaped depression formed, within seconds, a large mass of rock at the edge of the crater suddenly acted like a liquid and flowed into the bottom of the newly formed crater. This material then collided and was forced upwards, flowing outwards until it solidified back on the ground, forming a 16.5-kilometer-wide ring structure. Aided by large fragments ejected by the impact falling back to the ground, wildfires would subsequently go on to scorch millions of square kilometers of vegetated landscape. And yet, neither of these events would trigger mass extinction events in our planet's history, despite their seemingly devastating impacts. I hope that you enjoyed today's video, and if you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Also, I would like to thank my new patron, Greg, in Tennessee, for supporting this channel.